What's going on, everybody? Today we're doing a complete inspection on the ignition system on this 2007 Yamaha FZ6. We're following the service manual top to bottom, so if you got a misfire on your FZ6, we're gonna find the problem of it today. If you haven't already, please smash the like and subscribe button down below. It really helps me out. And with that set aside, let's get into it.
First thing we check is the fuses, and they're under the right side seat plastic.
Now pop this little cover off your fuse box here. There you go. Now, you can either pull out each fuse and check them manually, like so. Check it out. Look for the wave here. If you see a break, it's broken. You could pull it out and check them like that, or you can use a multimeter set to 200 ohms of resistance, or essentially the lowest level of resistance, and then put your multimeter probes on either end of the little silver connections here on the top and make sure that there is continuity across the top. If a fuse was broke, you wouldn't have continuity across the two exposed metal dots here, and that would tell you the fuse is blown. So either visually inspect them or electrically inspect them and make sure they're all good. The only one we're really concerned with here is the ignition one, which is 10 amp. So it goes 20, 10, 10, 20, 10, 10, this third one right here. So just for the sake of it, I'm gonna pull it out. Yeah, we're good.
Next, we need to check the battery voltage. So the plastic pods gotta go as the tank needs to be lifted up.
Now, this isn't a super necessary step because if your bike cranking but not starting, you probably already know that you have enough battery voltage, but it's a good idea just to check. So we got 12.73 volts. That's great. Basically, anything less than 12.6 is bad.
Next, you need to make sure the crank position sensor is within spec. It's located behind the side cover and connects under the throttle bodies. Check out my crank position sensor video in the description for more detail.
To get to your ignition coils, you have to get behind the battery box in here. So basically that means taking out your air box, which is Phillips screws around the perimeter, and then the pesky 4 millimeters that are under here. Once the air intake is off, you can take your battery cover and box out. Basically just undo the battery with your Phillips, take the terminals off, get your main relay and fuse out of the way, and then the 10 millimeters that hold down the top of the battery box, and then take out the battery box itself with this one over here and on the other side. The ignition coils are really cramped in here. You can just see the primary side of the top coil right here, but you really have to pull them out of the way to get back in there. I have some ignition coils for this bike off of this bike because I ordered some online recently. So I'm gonna show you how we test them on the ground outside the bike, but that's the procedure for getting in there. Next on the list, we have to check the resistance of the cap of the lead going down to the spark plug. To do that, with the coils out obviously on the bench, you can peel back the top cap here. I've just slid this one down for convenience, but you roll it back with your thumb. Roll it right back. It's pretty tough. Be careful not to tear it. And then once you got it rolled off, you can slide it back. It doesn't pull out, it twists off. So you spin it off. And there you go. You can see it's kind of threaded inside here and it just threads inside that. So now with this off, we're gonna measure the resistance of this cap right here. This cap should be 10,000 ohms. I couldn't get my multimeter to cooperate, but the spec is 10,000 ohms for these caps. Now we're gonna measure the primary side of the ignition coil. I have my lead set up here going to the blade end of the ignition coil. This is your primary side, as in your low voltage side. And you can see the multimeter is measuring 2.3 ohms of resistance. The spec for this is anywhere between 1.53 and 2.07 ohms. You might be thinking, Calvin's got more resistance than it's supposed to have on the primary side, but you have to take into account how much resistance the leads actually make up for. So I had 2.3, but when I connect my two leads, my multimeter alone creates with its leads 0.6 ohms of resistance. So that means I was generating 1.7 ohms of resistance in the actual coil separate from the leads. So that means my coil is fine. Next up, we're measuring the secondary coil resistance. This is done by taking off the two pencil leads by unwinding them off, because we don't want to include the cap resistance in this measurement. The range that's tolerable on this measurement should be anywhere between 12,000 and 18,000 ohms measured at 20 degrees Celsius. You can see we're reading 14,790, so that's 14,790, and that's within the range, so we're all good here. For an up close look, you basically see I wound off the leads,
If all of this doesn't resolve your ignition issue, it's time to move on to checking all of the bike's switches. All switches must be working to get ignition, and the list is long. Check the ignition stop switch on the handlebar, neutral, side stand, and clutch switch, plus the starting circuit cutoff relay, and then the lean angle sensor. If none of this does the trick, it's time for a new ECU. That's a wrap on the ignition system inspection on this 2007 Yamaha FZ6. I really hope this helped you sort out your misfire and understand where your electrical issue is coming from that prevents you from getting a spark. Please smash the like and subscribe button down below if this helped you out. And as always, have a good day.